Assalamu alaikum. My name is Akib and I'm a freelance web developer. In this video, we will learn about email verification API. As you can see on my screen, I open a one website, richard.email. By using this API, we can identify any email that's a real email or a fake email. So I have already set up demo. So this is a demo. Let me show you. So if I will put my real email address, if I click on validate, as you can see, this email is valid email. If I will put same email but with wrong some modification, now it will show invalid email because this is not a valid email. We can put Yahoo email address as well, and we can use Hotmail email address as well. So let's try to see how can we build this. First of all, we have to sign up on this email, this website, and they have a pricing plan. We will use a free plan. In free plan, we can send a 50 requests per month. Okay, so let's try to create a one page. I have already created HTML form for time saving. This is just HTML, nothing else, and here is code of that page. So let's try to write PHP code, that is very important. So let's see form first. So this is form, and this has a name and submit. We will check if submit button is clicked, then we will process our request. If set post submit, then we will get our email address here, email. So I will create a one variable, post false. This is something I will explain later why I'm using this. So now we have email address. Now let's see how it works. Okay, let's go back in dashboard, API documentation dashboard. We will send a curl request on this URL. In post body, we need to send authorization code, this code, with our email address that we want to identify. Okay, so let's create a data, post data. Okay, this data we will send to API. Email. We need to send in encoded form. JSON. Code. Yeah, okay. Now we will pass this data to our curl request. So let's write curl request. Curl initialization. So we need to pass this URL. This URL, we need to pass this URL in our curl request here. Okay, so after that, curl save hooked. We will set this true code. etcr card info and out. This way, true. Okay, and third is set opt. We need to show post data true. Let me write curl opt post true. Okay, now here we need to pass our post data. Post fields that we need to pass our post data here. Okay, now in headers we need to pass our authorization code. Okay, first we need to pass content type will be JSON. After that we need to pass our authorization code, this code. Copy this and paste our code here. Now let's execute our curl request. Curl execute in this CRL. Now let's print the response, if we get any response or not. This is our page. And here we will put this email and edit data. As you can see, we are getting response from the API input and is reachable. We need only these two fields from the response. Okay, this is the response. So what we will get is we can create some variables here like reachable is equal to empty, and I think okay, so here is response. We need to decode this response. JSON decode a result. Okay, now this response converted into array form. Now we can utilize this response in our code. So first is reachable. We will check here reachable. Okay, so we will use if else condition. This is a short syntax of if else. Okay, we will check if decode inside decode is reachable is equal to safe. That means it's a valid email address. We will create HTML here that will show below in table. This is booster class valid. Okay, otherwise well invalid. and range. So that's it we want to know. So if we refresh this, and if you remember, I told you post, I told you about this variable, why I create this variable. So here at the bottom of the table here, we will check if post is equal to true, then we will show this table. Okay, if post is equal to true, then we will show this table. Okay, so here we need to show our email. And instead of this span, we need to show our reachable variable. This. So that's it. Let's refresh the page. As you can see, it's not showing now. Now let's put this and delete it. So we are getting error. I think we are missing something in JSON decode. We need to pass true here, I think. Let's refresh and try again. Okay, it's perfect. As you can see, it's working now. So let's put some random email that does not exist. Okay, you can see response invalid. That's it for this video. I will put this source code in description of the video. And if you have any question related to this video, you can ask me in comment section. And if you are new on this channel, please hit the subscribe button and stay tuned for next video. Thank you. Bye-bye.